a single scull. Each rower has two oars, which is called sculling. But in rowing, some athletes row with just one oar each. This is called sweeping. The smallest of the sweep boats is the pair. Each athlete has just one oar and propels only one side of the boat. They have to pull the oar through the water at the same time to make the boat go straight. That brings us to the double sculls and the lightweight double sculls, where both rowers have an oar in each hand, as in any sculling event. Sculling is more symmetrical than sweep rowing. In the quadruple scull, each of the four rowers is equipped with two oars. A total of eight oars means this is one of the fastest boats in the world of rowing. The heavy, or the lightweight four, has four athletes, each with one oar. This is another sweep boat. The famous eight is the biggest boat and, in an Olympic regatta, the only coxed event. The coxswain is the only athlete facing forward in a rowing race. Each of the eight rowers has only one oar. South Africa is an up-and-coming nation in rowing. Head coach Roger Barrow is in charge of all the athletes in all the boat classes. He gives us an overview.
Yeah, the sculling boats, each person has two oars, and then the sweep boats, each person has one oar, which I think is a bit more difficult doing the sweep oar because of the balance. On the sculling boats, their boats are a bit more stable. Yeah, I think when the boat has more oars, it will definitely be faster. So if you look at a quad, which has four people and two oars each, will be faster than four people with one oar each. And the same would be for a double scull compared to a pair, where there are four oars in the double scull with two people, and only two people with two oars in the pair, which the pair will be a little bit slower. So always the boats with more oars, in theory, should be faster.
We would all be dead on, and it was who's going to sprint in. Rihanna.